Hello everyone. This tutorial, I will show how to custom slider gradient using Java Swing. Now create new class, call slider gradient. And this class should be extends from JSlider. And we going to create new JFrame for test. Now drop the class slider that we custom to the frame, but here we see the default UI, so now we start go to custom it. By create new class for slider UI. And we set this class extends from basic slider UI. And create the default constructor here, but it require to call super, so we need create slider gradient object here. Then pass the slider object to the super. So we set this slider gradient UI to the slider that we custom. Here we see this is the default UI in class basic slider UI, so next we going to custom and add more graphic. The first method I will show is get thumb size method, so we override it and return the dimension size. So we set width and height as 25, so run and see what happen. Here we see the point we move big than before because we set it to 25 pixel. Next override method paint thumb, and remove the default paint graphics. So we create new graphics 2D. And use method set rendering hint to make graphics look smooth. Now translate the location to the thumb location. Then start fill the ellipse 2D. So we can fill to the location 0 because we have already translate the location. And now we need create the gradient color by using method set paint. And we need create one more ellipse 2D for make border. By copy it and change the color. Then copy fill ellipse 2D and change location and size. I think we do not see some change because we set as similar color and only one border size, but it not a problem, let's start next. Go to slider gradient class, create two color object for gradient color property, and initialize with any color you want to show in default. And encapsulation both field for make getter and setter method. Go to slider UI, and the same we copy set paint gradient method, and change the color, but the color we should take from the slider gradient object. and also copy fill ellipse 2D. And we set the location as 5 and size minus by 10. So run it, but we have error. The problem is we forgot to initialize the slider gradient object. But we need to change the color when moving. And the color is followed by gradient color. Create affine transform to keep the old transform option. Then set transform here to become the default transform. So change the location gradient color to follow the track location. And for the thumb size, we also change to the track. And for the ellipse 2D location, we have transformed to default ready, so we need change it follow with thumb location. For the next we going to custom the track color. So here we override method paint track. And remove the default paint, then just copy the graphics 2D from the method paint thumb. And copy paint gradient color. Now create new variable for track size. But we need to create track size in class slider gradient here, so we can modify it in the property. Then encapsulation it. So here we get the track size from the slider gradient object. And we need to check the condition for horizontal or vertical orientation. Now we change this slider to vertical orientation. Here we do not see the track, because we not yet write in vertical condition. Just copy from here and need change some values. Now here we done with custom track color. And next we going to custom the ticks label color. By click on the slider property. First check on paint label, paint ticks. And if we scroll down, we see the property to change the gradient color here. And here we need set the minor tick spacing to 1 and major tick spacking to 5. But I need change the maximum value to 50. But here we see the focused border, so now let remove it. By override method paint focus, and delete all code in this method. So now we need change the tick color. First go to slider gradient, and create the tick's color for new tick color property. And get back to the slider gradient UI. But we now have option to change the tick's color, so now let's see the source code of FlatLeaf. Go to the UI package, and look for the flat slider UI. So now we see the tick's color property are available here, so we can see how they custom it. Here we need to override method paint ticks, and use graphics 2D proxy. But now let's check what this class come from. So here this class has import from the FlatLeaf util package, so now let's check it. And now let's copy all code to the project. So we see this custom class is extends from graphics 2D. And the graphics 2D class is a abstract class, and contain of more abstract method, so this is why we need to override all of their method. But we no need to implement anything, because we use the delegate object here. Now let go to the slider gradient UI and override method paint ticks. And just go to copy the code from the FlatLeaf slider UI. And in setColor method that has override here, we can use the tick's color here. And now we need run the project and close the form main, and open again to reload new ticks property. And thank you everyone for watching. See you next video.